Greek philosopher Theophrastus says that time is the most valuable thing a man can spend. More than 3.96 billion people today are on social media platform. That is more than half of world's population. But more importantly, daily more than 1 million people are welcomed on social media platforms. And if you are not available on social media, if you don't have a business strategy to engage on social media, then you are missing a big game plan. In this video, I am going to discuss with you how you should strategize to engage your prospect and existing customers on social media to become a new ACE mutual fund distributor. Hello everyone, I'm Shobhit. I'm a fin-based growth expert on a mission to help 1 lakh insurance advisor to diversify their business into mutual funds. I have worked for more than a decade with mutual fund companies like UTI and HDFC across the length and breadth of India. And today I am going to show you how you should engage your customers on social media platforms. The three things which I'm going to discuss with you today is why you should be engaging on social medias, what you should be engaging, and what are the ways through which you should engage your prospects and existing resources on social media platforms. Now, first talk about the why. Why it is important. As I told you, some numbers which are very intriguing. More than half of world's population is today on social media. And you know, more than 144 minutes are spent on average on social media platforms by all humankind. That is more than 2 hours. So if they are on social media, then you should also be engaging your customers on social media. The most important thing why you should consider social media engagement is the reach. You can reach everyone and anywhere and everywhere through these platforms. It may be Facebook, it may be Instagram, it may be YouTube, it may be LinkedIn, it may be Quora. There are various platforms which are available through which you can engage, but more importantly, you can interact with your clients. So the reach is very important. 24/7, you don't know when your prospects, your customers are available on those platforms, but once you have a strategy, you can reach them. The other important thing is it is very cost effective. Now, most of these social media platforms, they are totally free. If you want to upload any content, if you want to share any content, there is no charges. All you require is a good content, a good mindset, a good internet, and a good laptop or system through which you will be able to upload your content to these social media platforms. Other thing is it is very convenient. Convenient in the sense whenever you have time, you can do that. And then your clients are also having a very convenience to access those information 24/7. You don't have to wait for office hour to share your content. You can share your content, and more importantly, your client has to not wait for office hour to interact or consume your information or contents. So that is a huge benefit which the social media platforms provide, because if your content has to wait for only office hour to interact with your prospects or existing client, then it doesn't make sense. So what this platform provides, the convenience. Other important thing is geographical reach. Whether you are in this city or your client is abroad or any other city, you can reach within a matter of seconds. The same time you are uploading your content on any social media, your clients will be able to get that. And at the same time, the feedback is also in the real time. Whenever your client want to give some input, share some insight, or raise any query, you will be easily able to interact with them on those platforms. So the geographical reach is a huge benefit. Just look at 5 or 10 years back, how people were interacting. they were interacting based upon the date time, the office hour, or the reach was very limited to the city, or if you are going out of city, it was mainly because of your connections. But now you can reach friends or friends' friends or the only known ones across the world. So that is a huge benefit which the social media platforms provide. The other important aspect is the measurement. Now you can know how much people are engaging with you, how, what is the reach of your contents. If you are on the business platform of most of the media content, a social media platform, so you know how many people have seen your contents, how many people are engaging with your contents, and how much growth you are having of in kind of presence in of various social media platforms. So these are the reasons for which you need to be present on social media platforms. The convenience, the cost effectiveness, the efficacy, but more importantly, it gives you a credibility in the market. Now, if you are not on social media platforms, please understand, if you are not on social media platforms, you are not having a credibility. Today, if somebody wants to have a business relation with you, then the first thing what they are going to do, they are going to search on Google. And if they are searching on Google and you are not present as an entity, then your market credibility goes for a toss. Now it is a necessity, it is now no longer a luxury. You can't say I am not very convenient or I am not very well versed with Instagram or LinkedIn or Quora, then I am not going to be present on those platforms. To succeed in business, now it has become a necessity. The cost is less, the various platforms and helps are available through which you will be able to dive into various platforms in a very easy manner. If you are still hesitant, you can outsource those things. But my advice to you is you need to be present on those platforms anyhow. So I hope you guys are clear with that. Now let's talk about the what. What you need to promote or what you need to distribute in terms of content to your either existing customers or to your prospecting customers. The first thing what you need to promote is you. Please remember, I keep on saying, you are the business, you don't have the business. People will first buy you before buying any services from you. So you need to promote your values, your ethics. Whenever you are promoting any information, people correlate with you as a human being. So when you need to be very mindful of what kind of values and ethics you want to promote, and then you need to align those things with the kind of content you are sharing. Suppose you are spiritual, then you need to start promoting your spiritual contents. But it should not be that you are only promoting spiritual contents. But some insights on spirituality should be there so that people can correlate with you as a human being. As Shiv Khera says, people deal with you because they are more comfortable with you. And they are comfortable with you only because the way you handle them. So please keep that aspect in mind. The other thing is pre-framing. Now most of the time what I see is people start bombarding their influence with the product in terms of buying. Nobody is going to buy any goods and services from you just by seeing the advertisement or the promotion. They first want to understand you first, then the product, and then they are going to take an informed decision. So just by bombarding the policies detail or the scheme detail or so on and so forth, people are not going to engage with you. So you need to have a funnel approach. You need to first start educating your customers first about you, then about the services which you are offering, then the benefits it is going to give, and then you need to have them understand that if they are not going to get into those services, what they are going to lose. So first you need to educate them, inform them. if you want to get into a journey where you are going to use modern methods and methodologies to start your mutual fund business, then I would love you to join our community. In our community, we help people to have a detailed planned strategy to engage with the customer so that they can have a lifelong value proposition with them. Mutual fund business is a long-term business where you are going to reap the benefits over a longer period of time of what which you are going to put now. So if you want to know more about these things, if you want to have a scientific modern approach to doing mutual fund business, then I would love you to join our tribe by registering for a free 90-minute workshop. In this masterclass, I am going to show you what all opportunities you are going to get in mutual fund distribution business, then how to set up your business in 21 days or less, and what are the various platforms to use. And also, I am going to share with you what are the strategies you need to adopt to engage your either existing resources or prospect. The link is in the description. I would love you to meet in those live masterclass where I'm going to discuss all those things and much more. So please understand that no selling, you need to only pre-frame, educate them, empower them so that they are attached to you. The other important thing which you need to keep in mind is your social media strategy should be to have more engagement and not more quantity. Now, I have seen most of the people are in a rush to have a 30,000, 40,000, 50,000 email list or 1 lakh followers or a LinkedIn group of say 5,000 connections. But those things are not going to materialize. What going to materialize in social media is the engagement. If you are putting any content, if you are asking for some insight, whether people are engaging on those contents or not, whether they are giving you thumbs up or not, whether they are liking your or commenting on your things or not, whether they are sharing those contents or not. So you need to be very mindful of that. Don't be in a mad rush to have a huge number of followers, huge number of Facebook groups. Our strategy should be to just keep in mind that we want more and more people to respond to any call of action we are doing so. And your call of action should be to engage them, not to sell them. What I mean by that, your call of action should be to like it, to share it, to give their insights on in the comment section so that they feel more engaged with you. If you directly ask them to buy anything, then that is not engagement. You should be engaging your tribe. You should be having a call to action every time when you are doing to give their perspective, their insight on those contents. So please keep this aspect in mind. Now in this video also, I would like you to give your perspective. If you like the content, please give a thumbs up, give a like button. Wherever you are seeing, whether on Facebook or YouTube, please share with your near and dear ones with whom you can think that it is going to add value to them. So please keep engaging, please keep commenting so that I can get insight. Now this is the what of it. Now let's come to the most important part of our discussion, how we should do our social media engagement. To define a strategy is how you need to engage. First, what you need to do is you need to define your target audience. You can't target everyone and anyone in the market. I keep on saying you need to first define your persona and you need to replicate your persona as what should be your target audience. It is start with you. What is your liking? What is your friend circle? What age group you are in? What age group you are most resonating with? What kind of work culture ethics you have? What kind of work culture ethics you want in your near and dear ones? So that should be the starting point. Your target audience start with you. Whatever you are, people will be more resonating with you if you are targeting people who are like you or like-minded you. So that is a very important thing. Once you have decided what should be your target audience, then that is going to determine which kind of platforms you should use to engage your prospects. Now, if your target audience is say 20 to 30 years or 35 years, then it is make more sense to engage them on, say, Instagram. If your people or if your target audience is, say, 40 years to 50 years, and those who are in a mid career, then it is more likely that you should target your audience on LinkedIn. So please define first what should be your target audience, and then you should start selecting the platform with which you want to give your maximum effort. You should be present in all those social media platforms, but your engagement on some platform should be more attuned to you, because if you keep on distributing on all social media platforms, you will be exhausted and you will not be able to justify your contents to all the platforms. My advice is to select 2-3 platforms at max and start concentrating on those platforms, start engaging on those platforms at a higher level. Now, other important thing, as I told you, you are the face. So whenever you are engaging or you're producing any content, please make sure that your face, your insights are always available on those contents, because people correlate with you as a human being. So instead of sharing your photo, your face, if you start distributing somebody else's face, then it will not be more engaging. So please keep in mind that your perspective, your face is going to give much more credibility to your brand than anything else. Other important thing is it should be having a routine. Now, when I talk about routine, what I mean that you should have a strategy that in what days or at what time you are going to distribute your contents. Because all social media platforms appreciate if you are regular in your content distribution. So please make a habit once in a week, twice in a week, on which day, at what time you want to contribute. It is going to give you discipline also, and you will be regular to engage your audience. So if regularly you are contributing on particular days, people will be regularly seeing your contents and they will be easily remembering you. Please remember, jo dikhta hai, wo bikta hai. To jitna aap dikhenge, utna hi aap bikhenge. So please be regular in your contents. Other important thing what you need to understand is always it should be in a dialogue and not monologue. Iska matlab hai ki aap sirf khud na bolte rahe. Aap jabhi bhi koi content share kar rahe hain, aap engage kare apne audience ko. Whenever you are distributing any content, all content should have some call to action. सारे कंटेंट में आप कुछ ना कुछ ऐसा लिखें जिससे आपको ऑडियंस पढ़ के आपको रिस्पॉन्ड करे. कॉल टू एक्शन कैन बी प्लीज गिव अ थम्स अप, प्लीज गिव अ लाइक सिंबल, प्लीज गिव योर इनसाइट, शेयर एनी क्वेश्चन यू हैव, एनीथिंग व्हाट एवर यू आर डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिंग विथ ऑल योर कॉन्टेंट, देयर शुड बी सम कॉल टू एक्शन सो दैट दे आर गोइंग टू रिस्पॉन्ड टू दैट. Your success in social media platforms are only measured by the engagement, not by the number of people you are contacting. Because these mediums are so cheap, everybody and everybody is on these platforms. But in case they are not engaging with you, you are having no worth of it. So please keep this aspect in mind. And the last thing what you need to be aware of is all your communication should be very coherent with the end goal in the mind. What is the end goal? To engage them, to bring to a certain tipping point. Now, if you look at my strategies, my most of the call to actions or the message is to bring them to my 90 minutes free workshop, where I am going to tell them how they can build their mutual fund distribution business in 21 days or less. Same way, you need to be very specific from day one what should be the end result of all your social media content distribution. Whether you want them to come to any group, whether you want them to engage with you on any social media platforms, or what is your strategy, what you want your content to bring them to at certain place, or you want what desired result you want from them. So please keep this aspect in mind, then it is going to give you a very good result for all your actions. Now, other important thing is, as I told you, you should be very coherent with your message. At the same time, you should also be very coherent with the names which you are having. On social media platforms, your name should be same. That is your username. So my mentor Shobhit is on YouTube also, on Facebook also, on Instagram also, all places, on LinkedIn also. At every place I have the single username, that is Mentor Shobhit. You should also have the same name at all the platforms. It should not be different on various platforms, because people will not be able to correlate with you. So I am going to give you a simple free resource through which you can check the availability of the username. Suppose you have decided to have your username as XYZ, you can check whether XYZ is available on all social media platforms or not. If you want to have a coherent strategy, the name should be same on all social media platforms. So I'm going to share the resource in the description. Just use that source, check whether that name is available on all social media platforms or not. Otherwise, you need to do some modifications so that you are going to get the same name for all your social media platforms. I hope this session has given you some inputs how you should plan your social media strategy. In case you want to dive into a business of mutual fund distribution, where only today 2.5% of Indian population has invested, then I would love you to join our community. Do join our Facebook group, where we are going to help you in sharing lot new contents. Do join on our social media platforms. If you want to join our 90 minutes free masterclass, the link is in the description. Thanks for joining in. Do give your love and appreciation by hitting that thumbs up symbol or like symbol in case you liked it. Do share with your family and friends, and I'm going to see you next time. Thanks for watching.